Hi folks, Dave Waring here again from fitsmallbusiness.com and today's lesson of the day. In the last video in our How to Start a Successful Business playlist, we discussed how to set up your business website in four easy steps. Now that you have a website, it's time to set up your business email address, which is the topic of today's video. So let's get started. One of the easiest things that you can do to make your business look more professional is to switch from one of the generic email providers like Yahoo or Gmail to one that ends with your company's domain name. If you're a Gmail user, you can even have both your personal and business email managed through your existing Gmail inbox, which we'll also show you how to do. The rest of this video assumes that you've already purchased a domain name for your business and set up your company website. If you've not done that yet, then start with our guide on how to set up a business website, which I've included in the resources link below this video. When you purchase your domain from GoDaddy, you automatically get a free email account. If you also host your domain with GoDaddy, then you get at least one additional email, and possibly more depending on your hosting plan. If you registered your domain and/or host your site somewhere else, there's a good chance that they offer a free email address as well. The steps that we go through below should be similar to what you would follow to set up a business email address at other places as well. Here's how to set up a free email address with GoDaddy. To locate your free email, log into your GoDaddy.com account and click on the My Accounts button. This will bring up a page with several options you can select, one of which says Email. Once you click on that line, your free email account should appear and have a button beside them which says Launch. On the page that comes up after clicking the Launch button, you will see a Create button at the top. After clicking the Create button, a box will come up where you have two options. The first is to create a new email address, which is the default option. If you want to use GoDaddy's email system for your inbox, then this is the option you want to select. The second is in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, and it says Create Forwarding Address. If you want to manage your business email through your existing Gmail account, then choose this option, enter the business email that you want, and select the email address that you would like it forwarded to. After clicking Create on this page, it will take about an hour for the email to be set up and ready to use. If you're going to use the GoDaddy email system, then this is all you have to do. Simply log into your account using the link which I've included in the resources link below this video. Here's how to manage your business email account using Gmail. If you created a forwarding address, then emails that are sent to your business email should now be showing up in the inbox of your Gmail account. However, in order to send email from Gmail using your business email address, some additional setup is required. First, log into your Gmail account. In the upper right-hand corner, you will see a small box with a picture of a gear. Click that and then select Settings. On the page that comes up next, click the Accounts tab and then Add Another Email Address That I Own. Enter your new business email address here, leaving the Treat as Elias box checked. Click Next, at which point Gmail will send an email verifying that you own the address. Check your email to confirm that you own the address, and you're all done. Now anytime someone sends you an email to your business address, you will automatically show up as responding from your business address. You can also send a new email as your business address. To do this, click the drop-down menu in the top of the Gmail Compose window and select your business address. If someone sends an email to your personal address and you want to respond from your business address or vice versa, then you can use this same drop-down as well. Lastly, if you want new emails that you send from your Gmail to default as coming from your business email address, go back into the settings, click the Accounts tab, and then select Make Default beside your business email address. Here's how to set up your business email signature in GoDaddy. If you're using GoDaddy for your business email inbox, then you can set up your email signature by logging into your email account and clicking Settings, then Personal Settings. Then just select the Signature tab and enter the email signature that you would like to show. Here's how to set up your business email signature in Gmail. If you're using Gmail, then you can also set up a signature which will only be used when your business email is selected. To do this, click the Settings gear in the upper right-hand corner. On the General tab at the bottom, there's a section that says Signature. Choose your business email address from the drop-down and enter in the email signature that you would like to show in your emails. Here's how to get your business emails on your mobile phone. If you're using GoDaddy to manage your emails, then the easiest way to get them on your mobile phone is by downloading the GoDaddy mobile app, which is available free in all the app stores for the major types of phones. Just log in using the same login as you use on your desktop, with no additional work required. If you're using Gmail, then the easiest way is to use the Gmail app, which is also available for download in all the major app stores. Just log in with no additional setup required. If you would like to get your business email on your mobile phone using some other email application, then this is also possible. I've included links to instructions on how to do this for each of the major operating systems in the resources link below this video. That's our video for today. If you have any questions about setting up your business email, let us know in the comments section below and we'll do our best to help. Also, be sure to watch the next video in our How to Start a Successful Business playlist, where we will discuss how to get professional business cards for your company on any budget. To learn how to be a more successful entrepreneur, be sure to visit us at fitsmallbusiness.com today. Thanks for watching.